Natasha, I think, has Kavita Krishnamurthy and L. Subramaniam with her. Both of them are performers I greatly respect. L. Subramaniam and Kavita Krishnamurthy are with you, Natasha. And if you can hear me, I'd first of all namaste to them. Please convey our regards to both of these fantastic and amazing Indian artists, particularly to L. Subramaniam and Kavita Krishnamurthy from my side. And it's over to you, please, about the performance that they'll be bringing to this Madison Square audience.
We were just speaking to Arnab and he wanted to convey his warmest regards to you. How are you feeling when you get just before getting on the stage to welcome Prime Minister Modi?
Well, I'm very, very excited, and I will say it's an honor and a privilege to be here, because as a musician, today I feel I'm representing my country, and that makes me very, very proud.
Warmest regards to Arnab ji also. Sorry, I couldn't meet him now. I'll love to meet him after this. We're really, really very happy to be here, and I think a lot of interesting things are going to happen today, and we are looking forward to it. It's a great pleasure and privilege to play here and for our Prime Minister.
Can you give us a peep into what your performance will be like? How many minutes? What can we expect to see?
Well, I'm singing two patriotic songs, and one is from a movie, and the other one is Vaishnava Janato, but I've done in a very fusionistic approach, composed by him. And I think he'll tell you about what, and of course the national anthem. I think he'll tell you about what he's playing.
I think there's a painter who's going to be painting. So I'm going to be playing one of my compositions with my son, Ambi. It's called Journey. And it's going to be partly improvised, partly composed, which I've composed and worked with the musicians. So it's going to be a surprise painting, and I'm really looking forward to that.
Now, we've spoken to a host of Indians and Indian Americans who've expressed a lot of enthusiasm for the Prime Minister and also deep hopes and expectations from his speech. What are you hoping to hear from the Prime Minister, and what do you think he brings to not just India but also to the Indian diaspora?
I think our Prime Minister is such a charismatic speaker, and he knows what he's doing and what he's saying. The respect India has got in such a short time is amazing. I come to New York and performed in this same place a few times, but the people waiting there to hear his speech, the whole excitement, everywhere you go, they're saying, oh, your Prime Minister is here. So that kind of excitement he has created. And I think he has become a world leader within a short time. So it's wonderful to see that. It's wonderful to see how India is so much well regarded and respected, and we are proud to be Indians.
Yeah, I feel the same way. I feel in a very short time, he's definitely become a world leader. And also, I feel he's really, really trying to move things. And even between the Indian people who are here and the Indians in India, he's trying to build more bridges so that there's more communication, more exchange of funds, so that India can... I think his whole point is to govern India well and to remove poverty and to make it, probably run it like a corporate, so that it really becomes a very, very efficient nation. I think that's what he's planning to do. And I think he's going to touch the hearts of the Indians here and tell them that they also have to connect with India all the time and keep connection. That's what I'm hoping from him. And I'm hoping that there'll be a beautiful India-US Accords for the betterment of our country, of course.
Now, both of you have had the opportunity to play to different audiences across the world at very grand stages. But talk to us also about what it feels like to be at Madison Square Garden, which is a prime arena in New York City, and the place where you see the likes of Madonna and Sting.
I think he should...
I've done it quite a few times. The first time I played, it was with George Harrison and Ravi Shankar, and George was presenting a lot of other artists like Billy Preston. It was in 70s. First show was sold out, so we did a second show. I still remember, because the entire crowd lit up a cigarette light. It was like millions of stars from the sky. Subsequently, I played when they celebrated India by Bharati Vidya Bhavan. Our former president, Mr. Venkatraman, was there. I was asked to plan the whole Global Music Festival. Then we did a beautiful orchestral thing. I composed something called Global Music Festival. So then subsequently we also played for the Bengal Association. We performed, I think last year. with Mr. Prabhu Roy invited us. So I think we have played there a few times. The thing is, it's such a beautiful place. And acoustically, you know, it's a little tricky because there's a lot of reflection and, when you play. It's not...
There's a lot of security. I would have liked to have a little more of a sound check. But I think we've got to adjust ourselves to this kind of, you know, high security concerts. So make the best of it.
Wonderful. Thank you so much for joining Times Now. Acoustically, little tricky. That's how we're now hearing a description, a new description for Madison Square Garden and the arena here. It's back to you, Arnab.